I want to share an ocean story with you. It is about the power of celebration, and at its heart is the killer whale. Found in just about every part of our one world ocean, the killer whale is the most broadly distributed mammal in the world, apart from us. Near shore, offshore, polar, or tropical, they occupy a singular position in the food web, without concern of predation themselves. Fish, seals, penguins, sharks, great whales, heck, they've even been known to eat moose. Killer whales are in direct relationship with a dizzying array of species. They are, in many ways, the face of the ocean. As a species, killer whales are accomplished generalists. To be sure, tremendous diversity exists amongst killer whales. Select groups may specialize in fish, while others may make a living munching on marine mammals. Independent of prey type, however, all killer whales benefit from a formidable pairing of physical and behavioral adaptations. Killer whales have a host of physical features. They are exceptionally quick, reaching top speeds faster than many of their smaller dolphin cousins. Their color pattern, so seemingly obvious to us, actually serves to camouflage and confuse. And like all toothed whales, they have an extraordinary ability to see with their ears through echolocation. And then, of course, there's their sheer size. The largest member of the dolphin family, female killer whales are comparable in length to a full-size SUV, while male killer whales are bigger yet, roughly the same size as a small RV. But some of the killer whales' prey is bigger still. The blue whale, the largest animal ever to exist on the planet. In ways both literal and figurative, it is the largest challenge ever to face a predator. And there's only one that dares to tackle their immensity. On the face of it, it seems absurd. The blue whale can reach lengths 5 times longer and weigh 40 times as much as a single killer whale. That's a challenge that cannot be overcome by physical gifts alone. So what's a killer whale to do? What is the secret to overcoming a challenge this massive? Cooperation, coordination, collaboration. Killer whales are highly social species who exhibit complex group interactions within hierarchical dominant systems. That is to say, they work together to rear their young, to protect their pod, and to pursue prey, which can occasionally include blue whales. Only twice has such a clash of the titans been documented. The first time was 35 years ago, back in 1979. A combined crew from the Hub SeaWorld Research Institute and SeaWorld San Diego were embarking on a mission to tag swordfish for study when they happened upon a pod of roughly 30 killer whales already engaged in attacking a big blue whale. They realized the singular nature of what they were witnessing and, abandoning the original mission, stayed with these whales for the next 5 hours. Now, I'm going to share some of the footage that they took with you now. While most of the more graphic footage has been omitted, be prepared for things not to go well for the blue. Now, what you're seeing is a highly organized effort playing out over the course of 5 hours. Particular whales will adopt particular roles and work in concert with the rest of the group throughout the pursuit. 35 years ago, when this took place, the expert opinion at the time was that the dominant males were leading the effort. How little we knew, and still fully understand, about killer whales. If you look closely, you'll see the adult males, they're the ones with the particularly tall dorsal fins, largely maintain a peripheral role, flanking this 60-foot blue on its left and its right, forward and back. The adult females, on the other hand, are in close, driving the blue forward, steadily exhausting him. It is the females who are actually calling the shots, coordinating the efforts of the group, as killer whale pods are generally matriarchal. They exhibit a strict dominance hierarchy, ranked in order, top to bottom, with the adult females generally at the top of the pecking order, oftentimes followed by adolescents and calves in the middle, and then finally rounded out with adult males sitting at the bottom. Sound familiar to anyone but me? Yeah. Back to the hunt. In addition to the whales flanking and driving, others will periodically bite onto the tail flukes of the blue, weighing him down further and exhausting him. Also, while it is difficult to discern from this footage, eyewitnesses indicated that still other whales were constantly plunging underneath the big blue whale, preventing him from attempting escape by diving. Finally, you may have noticed a few smaller whales beginning to show up next to the blue. These are young killer whales who were incorporated into the hunt as the blue became more and more weary. This serves as an important lesson for the young, providing them an opportunity to develop skills which will prove vital as they mature. Now, I mentioned earlier that this is one of two instances of anyone actually ever filming a pod of killer whales attacking a blue whale. The second, filmed last year in 2013, provides an intriguing possibility. Given the location in which both events were seen, it is remotely possible that some of the young whales seen learning how to hunt blues in this footage are actually experienced adults taking on an even larger blue in the later piece. Regardless, any observation of a group of killer whales successfully overcoming a challenge as significant as a blue whale is both incredibly rare and immensely inspiring. Their cooperative effort, an outcome of ordered focus and group will, powerfully illustrates the simple tenet that many can accomplish what one cannot. I believe we have something truly vital to learn from the killer whale. Their living testament to the power of cooperation can inspire us as we consider our own relationship with the ocean. They show us that no matter how big the challenge, while it might be beyond you or I, it is not beyond us. Thank you. I want to share an ocean story with you. It is about the power of celebration, and at its heart is the killer whale. Found in just about every part of our one world ocean, the killer whale is the most broadly distributed mammal in the world, apart from us. Near shore, offshore, polar, or tropical, they occupy a singular position in the food web, without concern of predation themselves. Fish, seals, penguins, sharks, great whales, heck, they've even been known to eat moose. Killer whales are in direct relationship with a dizzying array of species. They are, in many ways, the face of the ocean. As a species, killer whales are accomplished generalists. To be sure, tremendous diversity exists amongst killer whales. Select groups may specialize in fish, while others may make a living munching on marine mammals. Independent of prey type, however, all killer whales benefit from a formidable pairing of physical and behavioral adaptations. Killer whales have a host of physical features. They are exceptionally quick, reaching top speeds faster than many of their smaller dolphin cousins. Their color pattern, so seemingly obvious to us, actually serves to camouflage and confuse. And like all toothed whales, they have an extraordinary ability to see with their ears through echolocation. And then, of course, there's their sheer size. The largest member of the dolphin family, female killer whales are comparable in length to a full-size SUV. While male killer whales are bigger yet, roughly the same size as a small RV, but some of the killer whales' prey is bigger still. The blue whale, the largest animal ever to exist on the planet. In ways both literal and figurative, it is the largest challenge ever to face a predator, and there's only one that dares to tackle their immensity. On the face of it, it seems absurd. The blue whale can reach lengths 5 times longer and weigh 40 times as much as a single killer whale. That's a challenge that cannot be overcome by physical gifts alone. So what's a killer whale to do? What is the secret to overcoming a challenge this massive? Cooperation, coordination, collaboration. Killer whales are highly social.